Giving the other person the benefit of the doubt is especially hard if what the other person is saying and doing goes against your own beliefs and values, which is often the case when you're dealing with a bully. This is a realistic dilemma, but as we saw in Chapter 3, the worst things you can do are to fight back in the moment or do nothing over time. Most bullies have been playing this dangerous game for a very long time, and by getting defensive or ignoring them, you're playing right into their hands. You're basically agreeing to play their power game using their rules. You're relinquishing your own power. Try not to fall into this trap. Maintain the I'm okay, you're okay mindset we discussed in Chapter 3. Observe and listen attentively. Diagnose the real problem. Keep calm and maintain eye contact. Remember, I told you in Chapter 1 that for a very long time, I believed that I was the problem? If at all possible, try not to fall into the same trap. Recognize when you're doing this. Are you trying to justify the bully's behavior? There are a lot of reasons why you might do this. Fear, a desire to please others, a need to prove yourself, or you may have crippling self-doubt, limiting beliefs and excuses. The list goes on. The only way to diagnose the real problem is to try to understand the other person's perspective. Always remember, your truth is not the truth. Assume you don't know the other person's truth. Try to move away from an us versus them argumentative mindset in which we blame them, they are the problem, they blame us, we are the problem. It doesn't help. Trust me, I've made this mistake so many times. I still do sometimes, especially when I'm tired, run down, and when Scar rears his head. Recognize that we all see the world differently. We all have different stories. However, clearly the reason that this difficult conversation is happening at all is because there is a problem. Or at least, someone has a problem. It is rarely personal, so don't make it about you.